All right, we know her from her great role as Shirley in The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. And, of course, the only person who loves Mahjong as much as my wife, Leslie. Here comes Carolyn Aaron from Connecticut. Carolyn, have you been playing Mahjong online during the pandemic?
No, I really should have brushed up on my skills, but I haven't done that yet. I want to play with your wife.
She wants to play.
As soon as we can be together.
Desperately with you. And I don't know if you can see us, but let me show you the 2020 Mahjong card. Have you looked at the card for this year?
No.
No?
Oh, great. No, I haven't even seen it yet. Look at that. Wow. Wow, that's incredible.
And can you tell
us
if certain years are better cards than other years?
I don't think you can. I think it's amazing that in all this time, every year, there's a new one. This one looks pretty complicated, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Less complicated, I suppose, the ongoing success and affection people have for Mrs. Maisel. Here's the thing that you guys have done, which I think is impossible to do. How do you think you have kept it so good through each successive season?
Well, I asked our creators that after the first year, when they won a bazillion Emmys, I said to them, oh my God, you guys have to start with the blank page. Are you nervous? And Dan said, no, we're just going to keep making our show. I think it's just them. And I think it's also a remarkably great cast and designers, and everywhere you look, there's just an A-plus person, so that's how they're doing it.
Well, I tell you what,
not letting down.
Speaking of a group of A-plus people, this is a group scene from this season, and we love everybody in it. Take a look. Watch this.
Take one to share and pass them down.
What is it?
It's a schedule for Ethan and Esther. Everyone wants a piece of them while I'm gone, so I'm doling them out as fairly as possible. And thank you all for this. I couldn't do this tour without your support.
We got a very faint copy.
Now, each time the kids are taken to a new recipient, please bring all their toys, books, clean clothes, et cetera, so they'll have everything they need.
Except their mother.
Let's keep things constructive here.
I can hardly read our copy.
Obviously, they spend the most time with their dad.
As it should be.
There are multiple weekends slotted with Moish and Shirley.
Weekends, that's the word.
I was wondering why we got multiple wieners.
That's a great slice of a scene. Carolyn, how long would it take to shoot a scene like that?
Well, that takes a long time, actually, because even though you can't really tell, the camera has to pick up everybody in a circle. So we rehearse it for a while. And, you know, their preference always is to put everybody in the shot together, not to cut like when you see usually on television, just say talking heads, my turn, your turn, my turn, your turn. So they have to set up the camera on tracks that go around the whole circle. We rehearse it and rehearse it. And then you feel like you're in the room with us, don't you?
No,
I felt like I was in the room.
You really get that sense that you're in the room. How many times does Kevin break script and just go off on his own?
You never, not even a comma, not a period with Amy. No improvising, which is quite remarkable. People ask the parents, the four of us, Tony, Maren, Kevin, and I, do we improvise scenes? And we go, no, that's our brilliant writers. They just rehearse us and rehearse us. It's the irony of the more you rehearse, the more spontaneous it feels. So that's really what's going on.
You know, that's
Kevin does improvise into my ear sometimes between takes. And let me just say, there's no more fun to be had than that.
You know, but that your remark is very interesting to me. Because I think that's really true. When you know it absolutely cold, when you absolutely know it, then you can sort of not necessarily riff on it by changing the words, but it's part of you. It is more freeing.
Exactly. Exactly. And then you just forget it all. It's like you forget your homework and you're just sitting in the room with those people within those imaginary circumstances, and it feels instantly spontaneous. But that's what happens when you play tennis with people who are so good. You can't even see the ball going across the net.
Last question, and easier said than done. Has anybody given you any inkling when production might resume again?
Not really. I mean, we miss each other so much. It's a metaphor for the way people in real life, I know, are missing their families, and we just can't wait to be back together. And I know everybody's working really hard to make that sooner rather than later, but like everybody else in the world, everything's uncertain right now. We have to make friends with uncertainty, because that's what's happening.
Those are wise words. Season 3 of The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel is available on Amazon Prime. Good acting lesson there from a really good actress, Carolyn Aaron. Go back to Mr. Mester and Ms. Holmes.